Please go ahead and watch the shuffling of the cards, participate in the brief meditation, and select the butterfly that resonates with your spirit to see why your bad childhood experiences still control your life today. Thank you so much for watching. Take a deep breath to the count of three, hold it to the count of three, and release it to the count of three. Let your mind settle into your heart. Let your heart settle into your. We are asking the Jungle Beauty Goddess Tarot cards, what childhood negative experiences that are still influencing my life outcomes today? You are watching the actual shuffling of the spread. I never reshuffle my cards because I trust the universe to provide the answers that we need. I call on forces higher than I to unleash the wisdom I hold inside. Let this message be compassionate and true to show someone what they must do. Tap into the infinite wisdom of your own inner guide. Ask it to reveal to you what is hidden deep inside. Take what you need and ignore what doesn't apply by selecting the color of the right butterfly. Listen to the whispers of your own inner voice and let it help you make the true butterfly choice with the lessons and insights that will help you grow and lead you in the direction that you choose to go. Let's see what the Jungle Beauty Goddesses have to say to help someone find their way. Hello, darling, if you selected the red butterfly, then this reading is for you. First, I'm going to go over the cards and then I'm going to give you my collective intuition about your particular spread. So first we have Jungle Beauty Goddess Sinai. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Sinai, who represents the second chakra and our ability to have fun, enjoy life, and have intimate and loving relationships with others, she says to you, take a risk. Next, you have Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar, who represents our third eye, our ability to use our imagination, our wisdom. When you get creative ideas, it comes from your third eye. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar's message to you is start where you are with what you have. Next, you have Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar again, who represents ingenuity, our ability to be innovative, have new ideas. And then she says to you, bring your dreams to life. And the last card of your four card spread, again, this is a very interesting hand. You have a Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar says to you that you should be creative. This is such a powerful, very, very, very powerful spread. So how your childhood is controlling your adult life right now is that you are a person, you are disconnected from your imagination. Your third eye has been, I don't know, shut by society, by rules. I feel like you're the person who tell everybody, you know, let's be serious, let's be adults, let's be, you know, you were taught that if you can't see it, smell it, touch it, that it is not real. And your imagination, when you, you know, everyone has an imagination. Now, when you were a child, initially, remember when we would, you know, believe in like the snowman, and we would look at the moon and say, oh my God, the moon is following me home. And we, you know, had to step in the water puddles, and we were curious and adventurous about life. We loved life. And then somebody said, oh, that's not real, right? And they gave us all of these practical rules to live by. So that part of you, your inner child, has been squashed by these practical rules about what is right and what is wrong. And now you are an adult who has lost touch with your inner child, with your imagination, with your sense of awe and curiosity about life and love. Now, the thing that's interesting about this, I don't think I've ever gotten one goddess in a four-card spread three times, but let me tell you a little bit about Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar. She's my favorite of the sisters, in the sense that she's the bad girl. Like, she is the person who believes that you can create whatever you want. Use your imagination to create the world you want. Change your reality by shifting your beliefs. She believes, now the thing about her, she doesn't get into whether the morality of it or whether it's right or wrong, but she believes that you have the power to change your world with your thoughts. Now, in order for you to reconnect with the little kid in you who once believed that in magic, you know, who believed in dragons and the butterflies could talk, and you know, this person who had this great imagination, you're going to have to open your third eye. And I'm not, you know, I don't know if it's always wise to tell somebody to open their third eye, but I'll tell you some things you can do. Like, for example, your third eye is located right here. Now, this is a lapis lazuli, and you could take a lapis lazuli or iolite, and you want to just hold it right here. Not that this would be enough, you know what I'm saying? But I know if you take I'm not sure if it's chlorella, but basically drinking water that does not have fluoride, so bottled water, meditating, you know, if you place this here. I also have an iolite, which is another gemstone that is really good for your third eye. Let me see, can I get it in focus here? Like, this is, this is really good for your third iolite as well. And you just want to hold it here, and you can say, Now, that's one of the things you can do, but I don't think that is going to be enough for a person to open their third eye personally. But I do believe that once you start giving something attention, other avenues open up that will help you reconnect with your inner child. So, you know, you have Jungle Beauty Goddess. Let me just go over this again. Afar is telling you to be creative. Now, being creative connects you to your inner child. It connects you to your wisdom, to your understanding, to your awe. I mean, just think about all of the wonderful things in the world that has been created. It's because somebody was connected to their inner child, to their imagination, to their third eye. The third eye is the part of us that sees an idea before it comes into fruition. So when you read a story, a book, you know, that's somebody's third eye is coming up in with the idea for the book. Now, the throat chakra would help you articulate the thoughts and writing it down in the words. And then you have your third chakra, which I don't want to, it's the middle of your stomach, is 2 inches above your navel. It helps you to get things in action. But I just want to keep the third eye in focus, because you have three cards from Jungle Beauty Goddess of Fire who represents the third eye. Now, the third eye has to do also with, I think the way Sigmund Freud would look at it is your super ego. So if you've been taught a lot of religious dogma or how to think or how to see the world or how you dress, you're supposed to do this, this is how things are supposed to be, if your third eye is closed, you have rigid thinking. And with rigid thinking, it's really hard to use your imagination. If you think you know everything, then there's no room for any new information or ideas to come in. So one of the things you would have to do is try to I just got an idea. So what came to me is that this reading is for a person who your caretakers, your parents, have been very rigid in telling you about what the rules of life are, right? As opposed to you disagreeing or fighting or saying, oh, whether or not you believe in God, or that's not what this reading is about. This reading is telling me to tell you that you need to artistically express your childhood to the world. So, you know how sometimes hip-hop artists, they have some of their, you know, greatest hits because they're talking about their childhood? Country music artists, they're talking about their environment, right? So use your imagination to go back to your childhood, and no matter what it is, and find a way to artistically express your childhood and share it with the world. That is what you need to do. So you need to be creative. Hey Arnold was one of my favorite cartoons. Charlie Brown, he is expressing his truth. So you need to use your imagination to express your childhood, no matter what it is, no matter what you believe in. Share that with the world. Another cartoon that just popped in my mind, I think it's called Rick and Morty or something like that. Again, here's a person using their imagination to share with the world their beliefs. So you also have Jungle Beauty Goddess, Sinai, who is begging you. She says that you should take a risk, right? Oh my God, this is such a good hand. Listen, what you should do for your second chakra, which is represented by Jungle Beauty Goddess Sinai, is 2 inches below your navel. This is Moonstone. Moonstone is a really good stone for intuition. And, oh, look, I got it in focus here. This is a good stone that will help stimulate your second chakra and get those ideas flowing, those creative juices flowing. And then another gemstone that you can use, let me see what I got, for your second chakra is carnelian, which is one of my favorite gemstones. And you want to put this on your second chakra to help with your intuition and get those ideas flowing. And again, like I said before, also for your third eye, you could use sodalite. This is a good one. And you know what's interesting about this reach also is that the two chakras that I have worked on more than any other chakras has always been my third eye and my second chakra. And do you know that those two chakras actually go together? They correlate, they harmonize each other. Like if one chakra is blocked, it always affects your entire body. But do you know that of all the chakras, those two actually work in coordination? So those are your chakras for creativity. The second chakra, which is 2 inches below the navel, that is our area for being reproductive, right? Now we're not just talking about having children, but we're talking about your creativity, creating ideas. So basically, I'm going to say that your inability to connect to your inner child and in terms of using your imagination and being practical, it has controlled your life because you have been looking at life in terms of like, I just want to be an adult. I want to go to work. I want to pay my bills. I want to be a good person. I want to save the world. And I think the message that's coming through to me is saying you're going to save the world by using your imagination, by reconnecting to your childhood and sharing your childhood with the world through some type of artistic creation, whether it's writing a book, a song, painting, drawing, sewing, you know, playing with clay or whatever, but tap into your imagination. And I think that you will see that your life, your joy, that's where your joy is located, okay? Your life will be filled with more joy, and you will have a sense of awe and wonder, and it will improve your relationships with other people, because Jungle Beauty Goddess Sinai also, with the second chakra, it represents our ability to have healthy and whole relationships with other people. And it's our partnership chakra, right? And to have emotional intimacy. So I'm going to say that once you reconnect with your childhood via opening your third eye, working with your third eye, there is even an oil, and I don't have it near me. It's a third eye oil, seriously. And it really, really works. And, you know, working with your third eye, working with your second chakra, that is going to bring about a sense of joy and wonder in your life. That's going to heal your relationships with other people, as well as bring more joy into your career. Another thing you should do is go back, think back to your childhood, and I want you to think of your favorite ice cream, your favorite cartoons, your favorite candy, your favorite comic books, your favorite movies, your favorite games, your favorite toys, because this is going to help you reconnect also with your imagination. And then I also, one more thing is, I want you to find your children's area in your home. Like, I practice feng shui, so this is just one more tool to help you reconnect to your inner child, so this kid can stop controlling your life, right? Or in a way that's, you know, so you can work in alignment so that you both are super happy and can have what you want. So in feng shui, basically this is a Bagua, and what you're going to do is you're going to walk into your house, and it's going to be in one of these areas. It's either going to be in your knowledge, your career, or your helpful people area. I like for you to walk into your home and look into the middle room to the right in your home. This room right here, or whatever. I like to do it room by room. So walk into your room and look into the middle right section of that room. And this is your children's area. This is the area that's responsible for your creativity, your joy. And the element for this area is metal. The colors are white and pastels. I'm doing this video right now in my children's area, my creativity area. So if you look in my children's area in my home, this is my creativity area. I have my Jungle Beauty Goddess dolls. I have metal circles. I also have, as a compliment, you can use stones, but I have like gemstones, like such as this. These are really nice. This is a I don't want to give you the wrong name, but I have a lot of crystals in this area. So this is my children's area, and I also made this giraffe out of cloth, and I use like these pipes that people use for their homes for the legs and the but anyway, long story short, is that my creativity area has a lot of creativity in it. And and remember, the element is metal, and the shape is a circle. So I have like a lot of circles. I have circles over here as well that you can't see. And this will stimulate your ideas. So I would tell you, for a person who needs to ignite your imagination and reconnect with your inner child to bring more joy into your life, is that you should put things in this area that remind you of your childhood or some idea that you want to bring to life. So if you want to make dolls or sew, then I would put a sewing machine in this area. If you want to write a book, I would put a book, you know, I would put, you know, pens. I would put the tools here, like a typewriter, not typewriter, oh my Lord, that I must be 100, right? A computer, an iPad. So, but you know what? I just had an idea that if you want to be a writer and the element is metal, I think an old metal typewriter would be a beautiful object to put in your creativity area for somebody who wants to write a book. And the reason I say that is because the element is metal. And I would paint it like with, especially those old-fashioned typewriters, I would paint it like maybe white or some or blue, because blue is a color of communication. Excuse me. If you want to paint, put paint brushes in this area. Things made by children in this area, because what you want to do is you want to stimulate your creativity and a lot of your favorite toys from your childhood. So anyway, I hope some of these tips will help you reestablish a healthy relationship with your inner child, so that in the future, you whatever career choices you have or whatever you're doing, you have a sense of wonder and joy in your life choices. I hope that makes sense. Well, I really hope that this reading helped you. If this reading does not resonate with you, give you goosebumps, or make you feel some kind of way, then that means that this particular reading was not for you. But perhaps you might know someone who will benefit from this reading. So please do not forget to like and share this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.